Namaskar and welcome to Startup Champions. This is the stage that celebrates the startup talent of the country. I'm Shubhendu Ghosh. Now, they say, you know, as a measure of success, sky is the limit. But for some, sky is just the point of beginning. Today we have with us shining stars from the world of the space sector in particular. Now, India, we know, is a leading spacefaring nation in the world. So far, the achievement, the space mission, has been synonymous with ISRO. But with the rise of startups, it has added a new diversity to the ecosystem. It has made it more competitive and more exciting. And the startups who are joining us today have made a name for themselves in the country and throughout the world. Allow me to introduce the startups who are joining us. First, we have with us Skyroot Aerospace, Pavan Chandana. Welcome, Pavan, to the program. We're from Hyderabad. Our second startup of the day is Dhruva Space, also Hyderabad-based. With us is Sanjay Nekanti. Welcome, Sanjay, to the program. And our third startup is based in Bangalore, Bellatrix Aerospace. With us is Yashash. Welcome, Yashash, to the program. It's in time now to meet our second startup of the day, Dhruva Space. They're engaged in making smaller satellites for the commercial markets. They also make satellite deployers and also ground stations. So in a way, end-to-end solution for space missions. They started in way back 2012, and they were one of the first private space tech company in India. Let's take a look at their story.
India's liberalization in the space sector has turned out to be a big hit with the entrepreneurs in this sector, leading to an influx of foreign and homegrown startups vying for a slice of the pie of the billion-dollar space industry. From the fabled city of Hyderabad comes India's best space startup, who are leading a silent revolution in India's space sector. Meet Dhruva Space. One of the first private space technology company in the country. Started in 2012, it found it hard to sustain operations without any external funding in its initial days.
Raising capital has not been easy. Initially, we did pull in close to 30 lakhs just to get things rolling. And we've raised 4.5 crores at 20 crore pre-money valuation.
In 2018, became the first company without any European co-founders to be accepted by a European Space Agency Business Incubator. Four founders headed by CEO Sanjay, Chaitanya Thora, Abhay and Krishna Teja came on board for its second stint. And the rest is history.
The idea behind this is that these bus systems can be integrated with a payload from any of our customers and then launched into orbit. So in the space segment, so we have these bus structures that are modular and configurable, ranging all the way from 0.5U to up to 30 centimeter cube platforms.
Dhruva is also actively engaging with ISRO for launching satellites on its launch vehicle. The firm is now planning to build a fleet of satellites and a distributed network of ground stations, which are used to communicate with satellites that are in the orbit.
I mean, the policies are shaping up. We are going in the right direction. There is still a lot more work to be done, both by the industry as well as the government, as well as ISRO and the related parties. But eventually, it will open up doors for a lot of people once the whole thing is set up.
The company has taken forward Prime Minister Modi's Make in India, Make for the World mantra, and is now planning to go global with its product.
There's been a lot of initiatives from ISRO, NSIL, Antrix, and InSpace now to provide us enough support for the private industries. The ecosystem was really well established, and now I think we are in the right time where we can use the ecosystem as well as the policies which will help us to build stuff in India and then deploy all over the world.
Besides US, India is one of the most attractive destinations to pursue a career in the new space sector, given the availability of high-quality university programs along with a robust business ecosystem.
Craig Technologies' partnership with Dhruv has been nothing short of exceptional. Our combined expertise has allowed us to provide top-tier services throughout the space industry, and Dhruv has provided a vital role in our international developments, and we look forward to our continued partnership.
The story of Dhruv showcases India's growing prowess in the new space age, where it has positioned itself to be a global giant in the space sector in coming years.
So that's Dhruv Space for you. A big round of applause if you can have for them for their journey. And one of the founders, Sanjay Nekanti, is with us. Sanjay, I've been very curious about that box that you have next to you. It's a satellite, is it?
Over the years, the size of the satellites has really shrunk. When you talk about satellites, one would imagine that, you know, the satellite is a size of a small school bus or an SUV. But, today satellites are the size of a small tiffin box or the size of a washing machine. And it is estimated that over 20,000 small satellites will be launched in the coming 10 to 15 years. And what we do is, we build these small deployers that go onto the rocket. We are working very closely with ISRO to fly this on the PSLV. We are also working very closely with my friend here, Pavan, from Skyroot, where we could launch put satellites for our customers.
So you are partners in the space programs and missions.
Right? Yes. So what this does is this sits on the rocket, and when the rocket reaches the intended altitude, there's a command sent to this particular box.
Okay.
And then the door opens and the satellites are ejected.
So in the space, those satellites, if they are small satellites, they'll fall and they'll fall into the orbits.
That's right.
Oh,
so
fascinating.
Here, because there is gravity, they just fell this way. But in space where there's vacuum, they separate by themselves.
That's fascinating to see a live demonstration of that. But tell me, Sanjay, we were looking at your story. You started way back about 10 years ago, 2012. And we also learned that the initial time of funding or finding an investor was a challenging time. How was that moment and how have things changed? There's so much focus on startups now. So if you could briefly tell us about your journey in that manner.
Yeah, so when we started the company in 2012, there were hardly any companies that were talking about building satellites.
Right.
And when we told, a lot of our customers who were within India and also outside of India that we could build a full satellite and launch it for them and do it at a fraction of a cost. Not many people believed in that idea. The reason was, the market was, probably SpaceX was not as successful as it is today. And, not many people knew how space industry was evolving. That had been a very big bottleneck for us to raise capital. So whenever we had conversations with investors, they would not believe that a 24-year-old can actually build a satellite company.
And that became your USP, making affordable products, affordable satellite launches became your USP.
Yes, so that's been our goal, and we've been sticking to the same framework. And we ran the company until 2015 and then put it on a pause for a while and restarted our operations. And because of the slew of measures taken by the government over the last couple of years, we were also able to raise our first round of capital. And it was not easy either, right? Like I met probably around 200 investors and 30 of them were convinced that we could do something.
All right. And Sanjay, we'll now hear from somebody who seems to know the team very well. In fact, two people. So let's listen into two very special people who talk about the team. Can we have the visuals?
Krishna Teja is, I think, one of the most disciplined and structured people that I've known. Chaitanya Dora, he's our party person in our group. But he's very good with numbers and extremely persistent in terms of, ensuring that the work is done. Sanjay, I think he's extremely passionate and energetic. He brings energy to this group. Abhay, I think he's very independent, very reliable. If you give him something, you can close your eyes and think that this is done.
I mean, I am learning from him how to, you know, maintain that work-life balance. So, yeah, pretty good. I think he's better than me, you know, managing that.
It seems like a group of friends just came together and saw a dream. We'll talk about that aspect, but if you can connect with our mentor, Dr. Sivan, once again. Dr. Sivan, moments ago, we were talking about the issue of funding. Dhruva Space started in 2012, perhaps when the opportunities of finding investors and funding were not very easy. How has the scene changed, sir? Today, a new startup looking for funding, looking for support from investors. If you could give us a bigger picture, how have things changed in the recent years?
Now, regarding the funding, there is, I wanted to tell one thing. One is that now this, I must congratulate and compliment Dhruva, that founder. Really, they have done a wonderful job. Now, that because of that advancement in technology, these satellites are shrinking, and that will make the whole thing in there smaller cost. I mean, the cost of the satellite will be very less. There is a one very good approach they are following. So it's one of the disruptions we are looking for. I must compliment him to bring out these technologies. And definitely, that is when we are doing that the development of such technologies, we need a lot of funding is required. And ISRO is really, ISRO or Government of India is trying to help them in an indirect way. Right. They can really, I can offer him to make use of our facilities almost free of cost. That way, it will be a very good saving for him. And then also that the technologies whatever required also we can provide him. This way, this is one of the ways of helping them to reduce that their expenditure and their that overhead. That is the one way. And another way of doing this now, just now we had some few weeks back we had interaction with the National Security Advisor. And now this, all these the companies, they are trying to form a society. Mm-hmm. And so definitely through that society that we can always look for some investment. And at the same time, definitely we can reduce the burden on them by offering our facility and testing that they approached us and he's aware. And definitely we'll help on them on this matter.
Dr. Sivan, you're turning out to be the best mentor that startups in the space sector can ask for. What would you say, Sanjay?
Sir, I would really like to thank you for all the measures that you have taken in the last couple of years. It's been the amount of support that has been extended by ISRO has been outstanding. We are already seeing a lot of interest from our prospective customers outside of India. Who are looking to, look at India providing them satellite solutions. I'm also very happy to bring to your attention that, the Vikram Sarabhai Space Center team has been very, very supportive. In fact, this particular deployer, they have been extending a lot of support, and there's a possibility that, this would fly on the PSLV in February.
Wow.
So, sir, I would like to also take this opportunity to tell you that a few of our customers are interested in utilizing the ground station network of ISRO. We would like to approach you to utilize the Indian ground station network and give that access to a lot of international players around the world. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you, and we'll be very happy to give support. Don't worry, you come at any time, and if at all any problem there, you please contact me directly.
Thank you,
and,
sir.
Your problem will be solved within 5 minutes.
Great, Dr. Sivan. You've just really made this program really wonderful. Please do stay with us. There is another startup that we have to cover. Before that, we have a question coming in. From our audience member here. Yeah.
Hi, I'm Sahil, assistant professor from Trinity Dwarka. You have just said that in coming 15 or 10 years, we'll be launching 20,000 satellites globally. So we have talked about using less fuel, making that satellites in very smaller size. We have not talked about space debris. So is there any technology or any startup working on that, or can we work on that also? Because that is also a issue to our ecosystem.
Sure. That's a very, very interesting point. We at Dhruva Space are very responsible with respect to the type of missions that we fly. So we try to have, we have not yet implemented it. We are in the process of implementing active reentry modules, so that after the life of the satellite is over, the satellite would re-enter and burn out during re-entry. That's one aspect of it. But when 20 or 30,000 satellites will be launched, there'll be a lot of requirement to track these debris. And an upcoming field for this is called the space situational awareness. And there are a few startups that are actually working on such technologies. There's one young startup called Digantara Aerospace Technologies from Bangalore, which is looking at building a space-based system for detection of space debris.
Right. All right, and as we conclude, let's get the final word of wisdom from our startups as well. One by one, each one of you, in very brief, the crux of what you learned in your startup journey, if you could share with our audiences and the viewer.
Impossible is nothing. I think you need to stick along. There will be, you might fail 100 times, but you will know what are the 100 ways in which you cannot get things right. And these lessons go a really long way, because you can apply these not just for your business, but also in your daily life.
And that brings us to the close of this edition of Startup Champions. This journey will continue in our next program. We'll bring some more young, energetic and successful startups to talk to you and look at their journey. We'll take your leave for now. Namaskar.